Bucharest in Romania, of course. I'm a psychoanalyst in Romanian Society of Psychoanalysis. And also I am a medical doctor. I practice my specialty in medicine as pathologist. I think and I know from different feedbacks that it sounds a little bit in contradiction or intention, because there are two different specialities to be psychoanalyst and medical doctor in pathology, because one it's so subtle and it's about soul and psychic and about our way of being, and pathology it's something in a way very concrete and very material and something to see. But time to time I'm thinking about these tensions, I think about between these two professions, and more and more I find from myself points of intersection and application maybe between the two. It's a kind of analysis in both of them, even there are different process or object to analyze. But in fact, both are connected with human being. It's not about something else, but it is in the same place, but from different part of view. So I remember very well when I first met and read a book of Freud. This was before our revolution. We have a big exchange of the regime here, because for many, many years and decades we have communism here, and a big ideology that at the moment become in big conflict with psychology and philosophy and all this kind of humanistic science. And for this, communism forbid psychology, psychoanalysis also, and many books in on this field are forbidden also. And it was very difficult to have such a reading. And when I was a teenager, I found, because a very good friend then of mine recommended Freud's A Psychopathology of Quotidian Life, and wow. It sounds so good and fluent for me, and it is, I think, really a very good book to be in contact with psychoanalytical thinking in a very natural way, because it's so applied in quotidian life. Then it remains in my mind, and somehow modeling my way of thinking. Yes. Then I started my training analysis, and after 3 years I applied to become candidate in our society. So I start in 203 with my own analysis, and also with seminars and supervisions in the society, and become associate member in the 209, and 2 years after become full member of the society. I think that more and more I am open to learn and understand about trauma. This could be very well, very much connected with our and mine history, because we pass through this big transition from communism, where the free of thinking and discussing was forbidden or was very, very difficult. We have a mark from that period, and that our self-esteem, our identity also as a group, national group, are suffering in a way because that period, that history, but also because We didn't have reparation and knowing and memories in contact with all that period and this transitional way of new identity, new life. And in this way, it seems to me like a personal searching and also like an hope to do something for us, for all of us, trying to understand and put in front and having discussion and dialogue, because dialogue wasn't something we know to do. We were such inhibited in a way for thinking and discuss together, and with such a big level of afraid and untrust that dialogue wasn't possible at all. And I think that it could be possible to start a real dialogue, a real exchange and trusting and a real freedom to think, to have ideas, to try to reflect, elaborate, trust to exchange this trying with the other without afraid, without stay like a stone and could not think and discuss. I think this is why could be an reason for my interest in this direction of trauma and collective trauma. My perspective now about matrescence and aging also, but matrescence as a psychological state of being could be think as a referential point. Now it seems that it is the core of thinking and of life also. There are so many direction with sense linked with this topic in a profound way. It sounds like an entire way of thinking, like an putting in a big perspective, in a referential point that open and link on the core of life and maybe also of analysis in self. That I recognize in myself this issue of being very, very touching, like an envelope for the core of things, it seems now. We discuss a little bit about solenoid. The author, Mircea Cărtărescu, proposed a fourth dimension. And that means, in a way, in my view, that understanding in a mature way the life and being in a mature way, it's a way of being in a different space, not in the same place, with ambivalence, duality, it is like this or no, it is like this, with argues, but somehow in another plan that could see also one faces and the other faces, and that it comes in my mind as being the problem of maturity, as a problem of perspective, and being very important as a referential point where we are in and how we think about things, considering what referential point. A story with a conclusion, let's say. It is about a king that dream, and he dreamt as being a butterfly, and after he was wake up and remember his dreams, have in himself a question, well, how it is I am a king that dreamed being a butterfly, or I am a butterfly that dream of being a king, because in his dream it was a butterfly dream being king. And it sounds very nice and very poetic in a way, And but also it gave me a moment of elaborative reflection, and I think that in both state, in dream and in wake up state, in fact it was a red line, the self, because in both state it was the same person, the same self that have the dream and have us asking who I am and what about. And I think maturity could be thinking in this way of having this red line or this referential point that could have different state of mind, different state of conscience, of awareness in the same person, in the same being, and being in contact with this red line. I think this could be a way of thinking on maturity. This remind me also a story, a real one, in contact with a big philosopher here, Mihai Șora, it's the name, 101 years old, and a brilliant person, I think, very involved in civic life, even he have such a big age. He is very active and very implied. He could, in fact, be a retreat with himself, with his thoughts, but not. He do things for all of us. He's interested. In a good way, not in a pushing way, but in a very friendly and wisdom way. He discover how to be in a natural way with in contact with his drive, I can say, and in the same time as an observator, but not as he did in his young ages, observating himself and trying to modeling his driving or natural being, but being in the same time in a natural way and observating this in parallel, not interfere these two. And also I think this could be a way of thinking of maturity, of having these two kind of being, an observator of ourself and of real being in contact with our drive, without interfere, but being in the same time in these two kind of statement. You know, like in I think in our Oriental philosophy, it's being on the edge of a knife, somehow having both part, but continues to go. It is a very thick way of being like this, but very natural because it's not like this or like that. It is both, not being ambivalent, not being one time like this, one time, but being in the same time. In a different perspective, you know, Brâncusi, Constantin Brâncusi, Brâncuși, in fact, it's in our language. It's a Romanian sculptor, very well known, I think. Have an expression that if we go, we climb a mountain, being in the peak, we have a big perspective. And I think also this could be a way of have a referential point and see a panorama and have a perspective. I think this is so, or could be maturity. And I think that age help with this kind of perspective. This could become in a silencious way in our way of see and think, because we have some experience behind, And not because it is a sum of experience, but because we can have perspective now going on. The first part of life after adolescence, when we enter in society and becoming active in relation, in loving relation, in profession, somehow we are pushing to be present and have ideas and work because different drive necessity. But I think at maturity it is something changing, because it is not nothing something necessary, something pressing. It become from inside somehow, to do things, to have relation, to love. To it's not a necessity to do like this in an active way. It is a choice. You have something to do. You have inside something to do. Now go outside to learn and to have exchanges for life. But having something inside and wanting to give, and this I think it is specific for a mature person. Loveless. It was about a family with a child, and first the father become in love with another woman and promised to be with her and starting to have a child. And after this mother go in another very exciting relation, and both of them are very involved and very in love, but with other partners. And the child stay in being alone and without their presence and their attention and love. The boy go out from the home and disappear, and they were very touched, very hurt about this situation for sure. But at the end of the film, of the movie, there are two scenes with the ex-mother and ex-father in their relationship now, with emptiness and not in contact with their new person in love, or not being there, but very preoccupied about themselves, and somehow alone once again, even in relationship. And then I, being sensibilized of the subject of aging, I thought that indeed sexuality as expressing of libidinal pick up at in this period, and maybe this influenced after the process of reflection and the maturity. Here there were two mature person, a middle age person, let's say, and they both of them were in love with different person, and the sexuality were there but not love. And I thought then maybe it is about this contact with drive and sexuality and libido, and also maybe maturity, it's a little something more or else, let's say love. Now thinking in a different way of loving, I think, in a real way, not only in contact with ourselves, but seeing another one in a real way, not being blind because our necessities, but having possibility to be with others in contact with us also. But I think that understanding, and not only understanding but also capacity of love, become different at maturity, I think. And this difference Maybe it could be because ourselves aren't so much in the middle of the problem, but being in the problem is not only love another one and without us, or love ourselves and the other, it's only a conjunctural person or a situation. But being with someone become real possible, I think, being mature, because this perspective that can include two person, two perspective, two other perspective that before are more or less in conflict, because I can be could be in conflict of being another one if I have not this perspective that we can be together and have exchanges and becoming like a new person being together. You know, it is something new that is possible in love. It becomes a new space somehow, a new way of being. Being there, but in a different way. Speaking about this referential point, I remember the story of Munchausen Baron, that it's a big liar, this Baron, and lies about many things. And once he said that he was in a water, but dirty water, with his horse, and he succeeded to go out, taking himself by the hair, and trying and putting himself outside this dirty water. And it is because he is such a big liar. But this could be a very good metaphor, let's say, for analysis and for maturity, because it is not possible to pick up yourself, but you need another one, so another point of referential, not in your side, even it's about yourself. I heard about this idea in analysis because, you know, people said why to go to a specialist to try to understand myself. Who else could understand myself better than me? It is a reality in effect. But it's also important to have another one to be in connection, in relation, to reflect, to be reflected by, and to know something else outside from your own mind, and trying to do all this only you with your own mind, it's somehow impossible, like in this story. Yes, I remember about the prisoner connected to his solenoid, and the fact that in a way, we are a seeker, a searcher for something in self, about the true self, and the fact that all the other are false, more or less false self, and that for this part of us, the true one, it is like a feeling of prisoners, and all our life and trying of learning and understanding and seeing back and have a perspective once and trying to understand could be like a way of search this part of us and find the real freedom. We are free inside, but more or less we are in contact with this freedom and this our life, I think, it's a way of being free from this point of view.